rising interest rate scenarios, debt investment looks attractive to investors. But should you be investing into a bank fixed deposit or a debt mutual fund? That is what we'll be discussing in today's video and understand what is the difference between bank FD investment and investment into debt mutual funds. Welcome to our channel Fintu and you are watching Friday First Cut series. I am Nidhi Manchanda, Certified Financial Planner and Head of Training Research and Development at Fintu. As we will be discussing the difference between bank fixed deposit and debt mutual funds, let us start by understanding and knowing the most important difference between the two, which is related to how these two investments are taxed. So let us understand the taxation point of view when we talk about these two investments. First, let's talk about bank fixed deposits. So when we talk about bank fixed deposits and you invest your money into bank FD, whatever interest that is being generated is taxed in the hands of the investors as per their individual tax slabs. So if a person is in 20% tax slab, then they will have to pay 20% taxation on the interest. Similarly, if the person is in 30% tax slab rate, then the person will have to pay a taxation of 30% on the interest earned. Here the duration doesn't matter, so whether you are investing for a year or 2 years, 5 years or even more, whatever interest that is being earned, you have to pay tax as per your slab rate. But on the other hand, if you talk about debt mutual funds, the taxation is quite different. There you have to check whether you are investing for a short term or a long term. If your investment is for short term, that is you are redeeming your investment within 3 years, then that is considered as short term, and the taxation for short term is similar to what bank FDs are. So here your taxation is as per your slab rate. But in case you stay invested in debt mutual fund for a long period of time, that is more than 36 months or more than 3 years, in that case the taxation will be 20% with indexation benefit. Indexation benefit is nothing but that you get some benefit of the inflation. So whenever you're finding out the gain amount, it's not just the absolute gain, but it will be the inflation adjusted gain that you will find out, and on that you will have to pay 20% taxation. Let us understand this difference with the help of an example. So let's say if an investor invests 1 lakh rupees into a debt mutual fund for 4 years time period, assuming this fund is giving a return of 8% CAGR, in that case after 4 years this investment value will become somewhere around 1,36,000. So once a person is selling this investment or redeeming this investment, 36,000 will be the absolute gain. So 1 lakh rupees is invested and after 4 years the investment is 1,36,000. So 36,000 is the gain. But you will not have to pay taxation on the entire 36,000. You can apply indexation benefit and find out the indexed value of the gain that you have earned. So in this case, the taxation will be somewhere around 3,566 considering the indexation benefit. So 20% after applying the indexation benefit, the tax amount will come to 3,566. On the other hand, if you invested the same amount in a bank fixed deposit, earning an interest rate of, let's say for simplicity's sake to understand the difference, 8% only. So 1 lakh rupees invested into a bank FD and getting an interest of 8%. Here the taxation will come to around 10,800 considering a person is in higher tax slab rate, which is 30%. If you are investing for a shorter period of time, that is up to 3 years, then there is no difference in taxation between bank FDs or debt mutual funds. But yes, if you are investing for a longer period of time, debt mutual funds will be more tax efficient because of the indexation benefit. Moving on to the second difference between the two is related to the returns. So when we talk about bank fixed deposits, the returns are fixed and guaranteed for a specified tenure. On the other hand, if you are investing into debt mutual funds, the returns are not guaranteed and this is market linked based on how the interest rate movements happens in the market. So that is the difference. And also if we see the range of interest rates here, in bank fixed deposits, your interest rates could be in the range of 5 to 7%. If in case you are going for a corporate FDs, your returns could be higher. On the other hand, if you talk about debt mutual funds, here if we see past returns of medium duration funds or long duration funds, the returns are 6 to 8% or 7 to 9% respectively. Now let us discuss about which of these two investments is more riskier. Now comparatively, if we see, both the investments are low risk investment because both are into debt investment space. But if we talk about a comparison between the two, bank fixed deposit will be lower risk because these are guaranteed and fixed return that is being given to you. On the other hand, because debt mutual funds are invested into bond markets and it is market linked, it carries a little higher risk as compared to bank fixed deposits. Debt mutual funds are subject to interest rate risk, liquidity risk, inflation risk and default risk. One of the major advantage in bank fixed deposit is that RBI insures your principal and the interest amount in FDs in a bank up to a limit of 5 lakhs. On the other hand, in debt mutual fund, no such thing is there. Now coming to the most important question, where should you invest your money, in bank fixed deposits or debt mutual funds? Well, here the answer will depend upon your risk appetite. Now, both these investments are good for low to moderate risk profiles. But in case you are investing into a bank fixed deposit, it is suggested that you park your money for your short-term requirements. Here you can park your money for, let's say, 2 years or 3 years time. Specifically, you can park your money which you need for your emergency needs. So your emergency fund is something which you can park in bank fixed deposit, considering if you are in a lower tax bracket as well. But investors who are in a higher tax bracket and also looking out for certain conservative investment for a longer period of time can opt for debt mutual fund. In debt mutual fund itself, there are a lot of categories considering the different time horizon, short term, medium term, even long duration. So considering your investment horizon, which goal you are mapping this investment to, accordingly you select a debt mutual fund for yourself. I hope it is now clear, and for any further query, feel free to get in touch with our tax and finance experts, and for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel.